Hi, I'm Matthew from OpenResty Edge. Today, I will demonstrate how to set up a reverse proxy in OpenResty Edge for TLS connections with SNI extension. Edge servers will listen to port 4003 to proxy requests to google.com or ebay.com based on the SNI name of requests. Let's go to the OpenResty Edge's admin web console. It is our sample deployment of the console. Every user has her local deployment. We are going to create an application of type stream. Select the stream application list page. Create a new application. We see two types of stream applications, SNI proxy and TCP. Our topic today is the type SNI proxy selected by default. TCP applications will get covered in another tutorial. Enter www.google.com as domain. In this video, we want to handle requests with different SNI names. Therefore, we need multiple domains. Click this button to add a second domain name, www.ebay.com. Create this application. Go to the upstream page. Create a new upstream. We give this upstream a name, say, Google. Here we enter the hostname of Google. Enter port number 443. Click to save this upstream. Now let's create the second upstream. And name this upstream eBay. Here we enter the hostname of eBay. Enter port number 443. Click to save this upstream. We can see these two upstreams, Google and eBay, are already there. Now let's create page rules to make use of these upstreams. Create the first page rule. For this page rule, we need to specify a condition. Here we can choose the variable name of the condition. We will choose which upstream to proxy based on the SNI name of requests, so the variable name should be SNI server name. Search for SNI and select SNI server name. Keep the selection string equals for operator unchanged. The type of the value should be string. Enter www.google.com as the value. Let's add a proxy target here. Select the first upstream that we just created. There are several balancing policies to choose from. Our upstream has only one server. So the balancing policy does not matter here. We just keep the default round robin policy. Access to this upstream is across the public network. Therefore, we set all timeout values to 60 seconds. Create this page rule. Now let's create another page rule. Specify a condition for this rule. The variable name of the condition is still SNI server name. Enter www.ebay.com as value. Add a proxy target here. Select the second upstream that we just created. Changed all timeout values to 60 seconds. Create this page rule. The proxy page rules exist already on the page rule list. The last step is to make a new configuration release. It will push out our pending changes to all our gateway servers. Let's click on this button to make a new release. Ship it. Now it is fully synchronized. As we can see, this sample deployment has 14 servers in the gateway network. We do incremental config synchronization across the whole network. We live update config on the request level. None of the application level configuration changes require server reload, restart, or binary upgrade. So it is very scalable even when you have many different users making frequent releases. As shown in this picture, we use 4003 as a port. Let's add this port to the partition of this application first. We need to go to the gateway partition page first. Open the gateway partitions page. We are now on the partitions list page. Many partitions are already there. We will add a port of SNI proxy type to the partition default. Click this button. Click the button to add ports. We see that a new line has been added to the list. Enter 4003 as the port number. Click to select type SNI proxy. Save it. you can see that the new port has been successfully added to the default partition. Close this panel. Now let's go to the Gateway Clusters page and select an Edge server to do the test. We have a node in the United States with an IP address ending with 0.84. We will test the page rules that we added using this server. We sent a curl request with the SNI name www.google.com. As you can see, the server is Google. That means the page rule that we just added works. The request with the SNI name www.google.com is proxied to the correct upstream. Now let's send another curl request with the SNI name www.ebay.com. We see that the server is eBay. Page rule works. Now let's do the test using the browser. First, we see the hosts binding on the machine. We can see hosts bind correctly. Then visit Google using the browser. Visit eBay. Everything works as expected. It is what I would like to demonstrate.